In this tutorial, we're looking at adding characters and animation to our game engine so that we can begin doing the animation and create the environment for those characters. Now, we got to get everything set up for Unreal. Unfortunately, at this point in time, a lot of the plugins that I'm using are not compatible yet with 5. While they will migrate over to 5 without any problem, I do need to start out in an earlier version of Unreal to make sure that everything copies over correctly. I have been creating my character. This is the main character for my story. I used Character Creator 3 for creating this character. I'm using the La Familia download from the Reallusion content store. Reasonably priced, gives me great stylized characters. I then went in and took the Oliver character and made some minor modifications, changed the eye color, changed the hair color, restructured the hair a little bit through sculpting, and also worked on the face a little bit for what I want for it. I may go back and do a little bit more editing before I'm completely happy with it, but for at this point, it's ready for going on to the next step. The next step is adding some animations to this. My character's ready to go in Character Creator. I've saved it. Let's go ahead and export it to iClone so that we can add some additional animations to the character. I've also got lots of great animations that I have downloaded for free or found on the Reallusion website or on other websites. So there's tons of great animations, mocap tool sets that I can use out there for creating these characters. But first, let's go over and add some animation to this. So I'll go ahead and export it to iClone. And that'll take just a moment. Now, while that loads up, I should remind everybody that is following, there are lots of great tools out there for making your avatars. Of course, you can use Blender, Maya, 3ds Max to make an original character. ZBrush is great for sculpting something. I didn't have the time to do that. And my animators and modelers are all busy working on other parts of this project, so I really couldn't ask them to do this. Plus, I found what I basically wanted. But MetaHuman from Epic Games is fantastic for creating very realistic characters. I really love the Ready Player Me for a more stylized character. But Character Creator gives me the more flexibility for creating something very quickly and be able to use that for what I want to do. Okay, that it has come over now. I'm in iClone, ready to go forward with this. Let's open up the timeline. Nothing currently added to it. I'm just simply going to add a basic idle animation to the character, which in iClone is incredibly easy. So I'm just simply going to double click on it. It adds it to wherever my cursor was in the flow. So let's pull that back. I need to get that back to 100 or back to zero. And now we can see the character's animation. Need to set the end of it here at the end of that animation. So this animation is 500 and looks like 502 frames long. So we can have the basic animation going there. Might be a little longer than I want, but we can always trim that inside the game engine. So I'm ready to go ahead and get this ready to import into Unreal. So let's go ahead and tell it that we're going to export this. I'm going to export it as an FBX, which brings up the dialog box for what it's going to go into. It's going to go into Unreal. Current frames per second is 60. We'll go ahead and go with that, and we should be ready to go. I don't think I need to do anything special to this to do it. So I'm going to go ahead and tell it to export it, save it to my desktop just so it's easy to find. There we go. And okay. Now while that exports, I do need to do one more step to get this ready to come into. As I had mentioned, we do have to use an older version of Unreal to be able to pull all these things in. Currently, iClone character creator only supports up through 4.27 of the Unreal Engine. I'm sure that 5 is coming out very soon, but we'll be ready to go with that. Fortunately, and I've tried this already, fortunately it's easy to install everything to 4.27 and then migrate it to 5. 5 takes care of all the transition and migration of all the plugins so that everything works correctly. All you need to do is on the iClone or Character Creator, hit the plugins and click on Character Creator and iClone Auto Setup, and then you can get the tools for Unreal or for Unity or whatever you're going to. So I'm going to Unreal. That brings up this window when you click on that, and you just simply download it. This will give you a list of files. Okay, so if you follow the instructions that you downloaded from the Reallusion website, the best way to do this is to copy the content and the plugins folders into the default folder in the system and go ahead and select the two folders that I'm going to need, content and plugins, copy that, and then I'm going to jump over here to my documents for where my Unreal project is currently stored. Then find your project folder, my baby boy, and go to the content folder and paste. That'll put the two folders in, giving us both the plugins and the content for our system. Great. Now let's start back up the 4.27 for baby boy. But before I do that, I'm going to take advantage of the fact that I've closed the program and get the other plugins that I'm going to be using for this project installed into the file so that to make the migration go a little faster. So I'm going to include Actor Core, which is from Reallusion, has a lot of great free animations. This is the sample motions. So I'm going to add that to the Baby Boy project. And that's now queued to be added. And I'm also going to include the iClone Unreal Live Link, which is a really cool program. It allows you to use your phone or your camera to capture facial movements, hand gestures. So a little bit of a basic mocap system built into through iClone into the Unreal Engine, which is a great advantage if you're working on an animation. And one of the reasons why I use the Reallusion software package. So those are there. They're queued now to install to my system. So I'm going to give this a couple of minutes to install and then we'll come back and launch Unreal and migrate it over. So I've got everything installed. Everything has been, all the plugins have been added and into the project. So we've got Baby Boy ready to go. I'm going to go ahead and just simply open that project. It should then compile everything, get it ready, and then we can start the migration over to version 5. We just need to import Baby Boy or whatever your character is into the project. Just drag FBX file into the system, and that will launch the import tool, as well as use the AutoCore or the plugins that we loaded earlier. And do make sure you want to tell it to import the animation if you want to bring the animation over. And I'm going to tell it to import all. It'll load it up and automatically bring in the materials for it as well. So this will take just a few seconds to do, or minutes, depending on the speed of your system. And there we go. And there's the animation as well as the figure for my character. So everything's set to go. Let's go ahead and save the level. And that's saved as my main map. And then we can exit this. Save the character to the file as well. That's a good thing to do. And then we will close Unreal 4.27. Then we're going to open up Unreal 5. With 5 there, I'm going to select Baby Boy, which is my project from 4.27, tell it to open. And yes, we want to make a copy and open it as 5. This will take care of the migration from 4.27 to 5. Generally, there's very few errors on this, but this will take care of our plugins, upgrading them to 5. So then we're ready to go on with our project. Here's our project. It does look like I need to do a new level. There we go. And in our content browser, there's the baby boy skeleton. I'm not seeing there. Okay. And it is, everything's there. In the next tutorial that we're going to do, we're going to create the scene that the character is going to be in, create the environment that they're going to participate in. So that should be a fun little project to do. If you have any questions, make sure you like and subscribe down below and let me know what else you'd like to see in the tutorials.